Hey everybody, I just was gonna make a quick video here of aerial refueling because it's what I'm practicing and I'm having a really hard time of it. It's well, let's just get to it. The basic idea with aerial refueling is you want to avoid running out of fuel, so they take care of that for you. And this mission is specially designed with aerial refueling in mind, and I changed the time to 7:45, I think. It was a beautiful day, clear sky, and we have two tankers up there, just brimming with fuel, and we'll give it a shot, at least. I'm waiting for APU to cycle up to 100, so we get some power. How to make fraps work well with the radio, so there's that.
Batumi, 411, request startup.
11, Batumi, clear for startup.
Friendly guy on YouTube let me know you actually call this the IFC, and this is the KICU, C-I-C-U there, and thought that was kind of cool, the actual terminology that you say.
Pull up! Pull up!
Just a couple little tests.
Altitude! Here. Altitude!
Good. I'm not sure, but I think this mission might have random failures. There's a chance of... So good to check everything. I had one mission where the front landing gear just popped off, no explanation. Another where the hydraulic pressure never went up on the right engine. So... there it is, yeah. That was a little odd. Okay. So we have to wait for the CDU to align here. So I'm going to speed up time while we wait. And it's flying. Back to normal time. And we have INS nav ready. So that means it's ready to go. So we just hit the nav button. And there we go. We actually have navigation now. You don't have to move like I thought you did before. Probably forgetting something. Okay, well, let's go ahead and where you in.
Batumi, 411, request. request taxi to runway.
Taxiing is very important. You can't control your aircraft on the ground, how will you ever fly it? So, I've had a couple runs where I taxi right off into the grass. You can get stuck there. How embarrassing would that be, you know? Having to have someone tow you out of the grass so you could get your aircraft out of the ground. I learned to always check this panel. Now see, I made a big mistake. My left and right generators aren't on. I was going off APU power. You do not want to do that. And my ejection seat's not on. Very important with how my reflight refueling has gone, or in-flight refueling has gone so far. And I can turn my APU off. No reason to have that on anymore. And anti-skid's supposed to be off. So other than that, we're good. Always check this panel. It'll save your life. Normally you would turn countermeasures on too, but since I'm going to be by that tanker, I don't really think I should shoot off any flares. So let's keep going. Look at a map here. Oh, they got quite ahead of us. So let's see if we can catch up. I'll use the time compression again. Hopefully it won't be as laggy as it was before. But we'll go ahead and let them know we intend to refuel.
Texaco, 411, request rejoin.
411, Texaco, proceed to pre-contact at 12,000.
So this is time compression. Let's get through some of the slog. Maybe I should have gone through the other one. Something just squelched at me. Maybe it was not. off the flight plan a little. I also never set the flight plan on the CDU to be the active. There, now you have lines on the TAD there on the left showing me the flight plan. Slowly getting there. Probably should have backed around.
Warning, autopilot.
Change the curves on the joystick, so that's a lot. Alright, so finally coming up on the tanker. There it is.
Five. Warning, autopilot.
Let's see if we can get over there. I may run out of fuel before I get a chance to refuel. We'll see. Okay, we're gonna have to make another turn shortly, so I can start the trimming process. Get my speed down to match them. Maybe. I guess the other thing I haven't really figured out yet is how fast is the tanker going? Because my map says it's going 275, but it's not going 275. It's somewhere between 235 and 245. And if I go 275, I'll run right into it. And here it's outrunning me easily. So my efforts to trim there, I got way far away from the tanker. I feel like this G940 just does not have very accurate trim controls, because it feels like, I don't know, very granular. Hit the button just a couple times, and I'm way off from where I intended.
Ready, recontact.
He doesn't like the way I'm moving, so he's not gonna drop the boom yet.
Ready, recontact.
Cleared contact.
There.
Infield, passing waypoint 4 at 12,000.
But yeah, right now, of course, they're passing waypoint. So I'm gonna take this opportunity to try to do my best to formate with them slightly, to at least follow along, so they can see the boom came out. Thank you. say, I think I've about matched his speed right now at 239 here. But as soon as he levels off from this turn, his speed's going to change. So effort lost. When this starts to happen, it's going to be a precursor to disaster, because it just drifts off and seems to just have no control. Okay, so I guess I'm going too fast, because I'm definitely outpacing him. Now we're in dangerous collision condition, so I'm going to drop altitude before everyone dies. Okay, there you are. And just flies away. It just seems to be damage the boom there. I'm about to crash the tanker. So I'm at 1233 and perfectly level flight with no trim, or trimmed up for perfectly level flight. Okay, someone recommended turning off the track IR. Okay, there we go. Yes, another waypoint. We're passing the airport again that we started at. Okay, I gotta divert. Time for a landing. A lot of fuel, because it couldn't happen. Back to 131.
Abort rejoin. Batumi, 411, inbound.
11, Batumi, fly heading 128, port 1, QFE 31.07, runway 13, to pattern altitude.
I don't have the fuel to follow the directions, I'm just going in. Screw you, tanker. You ruined my life. I've actually practiced on Batumi with ILS landings, but conditions are clear. Plus I'm running out of fuel, so I'm just getting out of here.
Landing.
11, Batumi, clear to land, runway 13. So yeah, with these videos I'm showing, like, you know, kind of from somebody who isn't a total flight sim expert, how they deal with something feels wrong with this approach. To be dropping altitude too quickly. The various problems and such that, why does it say my airspeed's 228? I'm confused by that, but okay. I guess we're doing okay.
Altitude, altitude.
Has to be the thing that I'm having the worst problems with right now. It's just, it's not working for me. There goes my adventure in in-flight refueling. I never even made contact with the boom. But landing wasn't too bad. Taxiing basically just stepped back out the way I came from. Might as well take a look at these helicopter models while we're in the area. At least the plane didn't explode. Whoa. That guy can turn on a dime. That guy has an AK-47 sitting on his seat. Why do I have this aircraft here in Russia? The Caucasus region? Okay, well, I guess we can do power down. There's actually some more stuff you're supposed to do, like pull that. Close that. That needs power, though. I'm not doing that. Okay, well, that's a video for now. The disappointing video. Next time, maybe I'll get it, but I just wanted to make an update and show the difficulty I'm having with in-flight refueling. So there you go, guys. Thanks. Bye.